Hello children, good evening all of you. Welcome back to 6th day class of polynomials and factorization. Children, in yesterday's class we learned some more algebraic identities. What are those? A plus b plus c whole square, a plus b whole cube and a minus b whole cube. Based on these three identities we have completed some problems. Okay, today we will see some more identities and problems based on those identities. Okay children, today verify x cube plus y cube is equal to x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. So verify means here LHS is x cube plus y cube. Is it equal to x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square? So let's take RHS. RHS is equal to x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. So now we have to multiply this. So let this is a single term. So now this x into this term. So x into x square minus xy plus y square. Again this y into this term. So plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. X into x, it is x cube, minus x into xy. X into x, it is x square and y, plus x into y square, it is xy square. Next, plus y into x square, yx square, minus y into xy, that is also x, y into y, y square. Again plus into plus, plus y into y square, it is y cube. Now I am opening the brackets. X cube minus x square y plus xy square plus yx square can be written as x square y plus into minus minus xy square. Here we have positive sign plus. Therefore in opening the brackets there is no change in the signs. Okay. So minus x square y plus x square y getting cancelled, and plus xy square and minus xy square getting cancelled. So what are the terms remaining here? X cube plus y cube, that is our LHS. Okay children, so x cube plus y cube is definitely equal to x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. Okay. Now we will see whether this equation is identity or not. How to check it is identity or not? So we have to take some values for x and y. And if you substitute those x and y in LHS and RHS, we have to get the same value. Okay, shall we check children? Okay children. To verify whether it is identity or not, let x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. First, let's check for LHS. LHS is equal to x cube plus y cube. That means in place of x we have to write 1 and in place of y we have to write 2. So x cube means 1 cube plus y cube means it is 2 cube. 1 cube, 1 into 1 into 1, it is 1. Plus 2 cube, 2 2 ja 4, 4 2 ja 8. 1 plus 8, 9. So the value of LHS is 9. Now, we will take the RHS. What will be the value of RHS? If x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. So RHS, what is RHS here? X plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. So what is x? 1 plus y means it is 2. into x square 1 square minus x into y. X is 1 and y is 2. 1 into 2 plus y square, that is 2 square. 1 plus 2, 3. 1 square means it is 1 minus 1 into 2. 2 plus 2 square, 2 2 is 4. 3 into 1 minus 2 plus 4. 1 minus 2 means it is minus 1. Plus 4 it is 3. Otherwise, 1 plus 4, 5. Minus 2 it is 3. 3, 3 is 9. See children, here LHS is equal to 9 and RHS is also equal to 9. If you take some more values, for x is equal to any other value and y is equal to any other value also, if you check for LHS and RHS, you will get the same value, not the 9. Whatever you get in the LHS, you will get the same answer for RHS also. Therefore, definitely we can say that this is a identity. Okay, children? Okay, children, we will see one problem on this identity. Factorize 27a cube plus 64b cube. It is in which form? It has only two terms. And that term a cube, variables are in cube. So, what is the formula? X cube plus y cube. So, we know that x cube plus y cube is equal to x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. So, what is the problem given to us? 27a cube plus 64b cube. That means, in place of x, we have 27a cube. In place of y cube, we have 64b cube. So, here we have x cube. So, what will be the value of x from here? If x cube is equal to 27a cube, 27, you observe children, 3 9s are 27 and 3 3s are 20, sorry, 3 3s are 9. That means 3 into 3 into 3 is 27. So, 27 can be written as 3 cube and a cube. 3 cube a cube means it is 3a whole power 3. If it is x cube is equal to 3a whole power 3. So, what is x here? X is equal to 3a. That means 27a cube can be written as 3a whole power 3 plus. Now, what is 64b cube? 64b cube is equal to y cube. So, 64 in yesterday's class also we got it. 4, 4 ja 16 and 16, 4 ja 64. So, 64 can be written as 4 cube b cube. So, 4 cube b cube means it is 4b whole power 3. Y cube is equal to 4b whole power 3. That means y is equal to 4b. So, 64b cube can be written as 4b whole power 3. So, 3a whole power 3 plus 4b whole power 3. Now, it is easy for us to factorize. What is the factorization of x cube plus y cube? X plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. So, 3a whole power 3 plus 4b whole power 3 is equal to x plus y. X is 3a. So, 3a plus y is 4b. 3a plus 4b into x square, that is 3a whole square minus x into y. X is 3a and y is 4b plus y square, 4b whole square. Next, 3a plus 4b into 3a whole square. 3a whole square means children, 3a can be multiplied 2 times. 3a into 3a. 3 3s are 9 and a into a is 9a square. 9a square minus 3 4 are 12 a into b ab plus 4 b square and 4 b is multiplied 2 times 4 4 are 16 and b into b is b square 16 b square. Okay children, so 27 a cube plus 64 b cube is equal to 3a plus 4b into 9a square minus 12ab plus 16b square. One more identity children, x cube minus y cube. It is also just like x cube plus y cube, but here we have plus y cube and here we have minus y cube. That means in the given equation in place of y we have minus. So for this the answer may be, answer is x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square. You verify this children. If you multiply these two terms, definitely you will get x cube minus y cube. And also check for this identity. Is it identity or not? So you take some value for x and some other value for y and check for LHS value and RHS value. Okay children, using this identity, you have to do this problem. 343 y cube minus 1000, you have to factorize this. But how to write, is it in x cube minus y cube? So first term we have variable y in the form of y cube. Okay, minus is there. So what about this 1000 and this 343? You observe children, if you know the cubes, definitely you will get it. 343 is nothing but 7 cube. If you don't know this, you factorize it. 7. 749 ja 343 and 77 ja 49. So 343 can be written as 7 cube y cube minus 1000, you know children, 10 into 10 into 10. That means it can be written as 10 cube. So 7 cube y cube means it is 7 y cube whole cube minus 10 cube. So in place of x, you have 7 y and in place of y, you have 10. Okay children, with this you can do the problem using this identity. Okay. Okay children, one more identity. A cube plus B cube plus C cube minus 3ABC is equal to A plus B plus C into A square plus B square plus C square minus AB minus BC minus CA. It is also one identity. And you check, if you multiply these two terms, definitely you will get A cube plus B cube plus C cube minus 3ABC. Okay children, you verify this. Based on this identity, we will do so one problem. Factorize 27x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz. We have 4 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4. And also variables in cube. So here also we have a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc, 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. Okay. So we will compare this with this identity. A cube plus, first we will write the identity. A cube plus B cube plus C cube minus 3. Sorry. A cube plus B cube plus C cube minus 3ABC is equal to A plus B plus C into A square plus B square plus C square minus AB minus BC minus CA. So what is the given problem? 27x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz. How to do this? A cube. In place of A cube, we have 27x cube. In place of B cube, we have Y cube. In place of C cube, we have Z cube. And in place of 3ABC, we have 9XYZ. So, we have to check, is this is comparable with this or not? if a cube is equal to 27 x cube. So 27 can be written as, you all know children, 3 cube is 27. 3 cube x cube. That means it is 3x whole cube. So a cube, it can be written as 3x whole power 3. Okay. Next, b cube is equal to y cube. That means b is equal to y. And z cube, c cube is equal to z cube. That means c is equal to z. Now, 3abc is equal to 9xyz. So, 3, a means what is a here? A is 3x. Into what is b? B is y. And what is c? C is z. 3 3s are 9 into xyz. Okay children, so this can be written as 3x whole cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz is equal to 3x whole cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz is equal to a plus b plus c. What is a children? A is 3x plus what is b? B is y plus what is c? C is z into a square 3x whole square plus b square y square plus c square means it is z square minus ab. A means 3x, b means y. 3x into y minus bc. Bc means yz minus ca. C is z and a is 3x. So z into 3x. Now 3x plus y plus z into 3x whole square. 3x whole square means 3x can be multiplied 2 times. 3 3s are 9 and x into x, x square plus y square plus z square minus 3xy minus yz minus 3zx. Okay children? Okay children, one more problem. Verify x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to 1 by 2 into x plus y plus z into x minus y whole square plus y minus z whole square plus z minus x whole square. We have identity x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz in just previous problem. We learnt about this. Okay children? So we will leave this LHS. Now I will take RHS. And if we simplify this, we have to get the factorization of this x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. Okay? Half of x plus y plus z into x minus y whole square plus y minus z whole square plus z minus x whole square. X plus y plus z. You have to check to simplify. How to simplify? Is there any keywords to do this? We cannot able to do anything for x plus y plus z. But here x minus y whole square, it is in the form of a minus b whole square. You know children, what is the formula for a minus b whole square? It is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay. Now, x minus y whole square can be simplified as this form. So, x minus y whole square means it is x square minus 2xy plus y square. Okay. Next, y minus z whole square, it is also same a minus b whole square. So y square minus 2yz plus z square. plus same z minus x whole square. Z square minus 2zx plus x square. Okay. Now, what we have to do? Half of x plus y plus z into, we have to simplify this. You observe, children, here we are getting repeated terms, x square and plus x square. X square plus x square means it is 2x square, and y square plus y square, it is 2y square, and also z square plus z square, 2z square, and 2xy, so minus 2xy, minus 2yz, and minus 2zx. Okay, children, if you observe, 2 is common in all the terms. So, 1 by 2 into x plus y plus z into, I will take 2 common outside the bracket. So, what are the remaining terms? X square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz and minus zx. You observe, children, all these terms in the multiplication, and this 2 is in denominator and this 2 is in numerator. So, x plus y plus z, the remaining terms are x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy, minus yz and minus zx. You observe, children, this is the previous problem identity. So, it is nothing y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. You observe, this is our LHS. Okay, children? So, LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, we verified this problem. Okay. Okay, children, one more problem. If x plus y plus z is equal to 0, then prove that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. So, what is given here? X plus y plus z is equal to 0. So, sum of three terms is equal to 0. We have to prove x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. You observe, children, we have just x plus y plus z is equal to 0. But in the what we have to prove, x cube plus y cube plus z cube. That means we need cubes for these variables. So, I will do, if I write x plus y plus z transforms that side, it is minus z. X plus y is equal to minus z. Let it be 1. So, we need cubes. So, I will do cubing on both sides. For the equation 1. If x plus y is equal to minus z and cubing on both sides, that means x plus y whole cube is equal to minus z whole cube. It is in which form, children? A plus B whole cube. You know, children, yesterday's class we learnt about this. A plus B whole cube is equal to A cube plus 3A square B plus 3AB square plus B cube. And also we have one more formula. If I take 3AB as common, A cube plus B cube plus 3AB into A plus B. Okay. Now, in this problem, we will use this identity. So, in place of x plus y whole cube, a plus b whole cube, we have to write a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. So, x cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y is equal to minus z cube. Minus z cube means minus z can be multiplied 3 times. Z into z into z is z cube, minus into minus into minus. That is minus. So, minus z Q. Okay, now you observe, children, here we have x plus y, but from the y equation 1, x plus y is nothing but minus z. So in place of x plus y, I will write minus z. X cube plus y cube plus 3xy into minus z, that is equal to minus z cube. Since from equation 1, okay, so it is written as x cube plus y cube plus into minus minus 3xyz is equal to minus z cube. Almost we reached, children. You observe x cube plus y cube plus z cube. Already I have x cube plus y cube. So z cube, it is other side of the is equal to. So if I bring this side, it will become plus z cube. And minus 3xyz, if we transform that side, it will become plus 3xyz. X cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to, if I transform that side, it will become 3xyz, and no need to write plus. You observe, children, this is the what we need to prove. X cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. You will get the problems based on this also, this equation also. Okay, children. Find the value of minus 10 cube plus 7 cube plus 3 cube without calculating the cubes. So if they ask, find the value of minus 10 cube plus 7 cube plus 3 cube, what will we do? Minus 10 cube means minus 10 is multiplied 3 times, and 7 cube 7 is multiplied 3 times, and 3 cube 3 is multiplied 3 times, and we will add all those terms. But without calculating the cubes, we have to find this value. Okay. You observe, children, in previous problem, what we have proved? X cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. But here we have a condition. If x plus y plus z is equal to 0, then only x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. So here you check in the given form, minus 10 cube plus 7 cube plus 3 cube. Here, if we take a is equal to minus 10, b is equal to 7, and c is equal to 3. We find the value of a plus b plus c. Minus 10 plus 7 plus 3. 7 plus 3 is 10. Minus 10 plus 10 is 0. Since here a plus b plus c is equal to 0, definitely we will get a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. That means minus 10 cube plus 7 cube plus 3 cube is equal to, what will be the answer, children? 3abc. 3 into a means minus 10, into b means 7, into c means 3. So can you multiply that, children? Okay. So otherwise you do. 3 3s are 9. 9 7 are 63. 63 into minus 10, that is 630. You can multiply in any order. I am doing with the easy level. Okay. Okay, children, one more problem. Find the value of 1 by 2 whole cube plus 1 by 3 whole cube minus 5 by 6 whole cube without calculating the cubes. So this is also same type of problem. A cube plus B cube plus c cube, but in place of plus we have minus here. So here x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. If x plus y plus z is equal to 0, we can write it as, if a plus b plus c is equal to 0, then a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. In any terms of variables, we can say the identities, whether it is in xy's or whether it is in ab's. Okay. Now, so first we will calculate what is the value of 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 5 by 6. Okay. So that means 5/6 whole cube is equal to -5/6 × -5/6 × -5/6 minus into minus plus plus into minus minus. So if I write here plus and minus 5/6 also doesn't change the value of this term. Okay, that's why I'm writing here. So first we will take the LCM for these two. 2 3 6. Otherwise you can cross multiply also. 2 3 6. 3 1 3 plus 2 1 2. -5/6. 3 plus 2 5/6 -5/6. Clearly 5/6 -5/6 is 0. Here since 1/2 plus 1/3 plus -5/6 is equal to 0. Definitely according to this identity, 1/2 whole cube plus 1/3 whole cube plus -5/6 whole cube is equal to what will children? 3abc. So 3 into a means it is 1/2 into b means it is 1/3 into c means it is -5/6. Okay. So 3 in the numerator and 3 in the denominator getting cancelled. So what are the remaining terms? 1 1 1 1 into -5 -5/2 6 12. Okay children, give possible expressions for the length and breadth of the rectangle whose area is given by 4a² + 4a - 3. So what is given? What we have to find? We have to find, give possible expressions for the length and breadth. That means we have to find the length and breadth of the rectangle. What is the length of the rectangle and breadth of the rectangle we have to find? Let L is equal to length and B is equal to breadth. But to find this, what is given? Whose area is given by 4a² + 4a - 3. That means area of the rectangle is given. What is area of the rectangle? 4a² + 4a - 3. But you know what is the formula for area of the rectangle? It is length into breadth. So length into breadth is equal to what is given? 4a² + 4a - 3. That means it is a quadratic expression. Since it is a quadratic expression, it can be factorized as product of two linear expressions. So one expression is length and one expression is breadth. So that means to find the length and breadth of the rectangle, first we have to factorize this quadratic expression. Okay. So how to factorize this, children? (4a² + 4a - 3). What is the coefficient of a square here? 4. And constant term is 3. That is -3. 4 × -3. That is -12. So we have to write the factors for -12. To get the their sum is +4, coefficient of a. 6 × 2 = 12. It is -6 × 2 or 6 × -2 to get -12. So observe children, to get +4. We have to add 6 + -2 = -12. Otherwise 6 - 2 = +4. So 4a can be written as 6a - 2a. So 4a² plus 6a minus 2a minus 3. So how to factorize this? We have to take common out of these two terms and these two terms. So you observe, children, 4a square can be written as 2 into 2, 2, 2 is 4. And a square is a into a. Again, 6a, 2 into 3, minus 2a, minus 3. 2 is common in both the terms, and a is also common in both the terms. So, if I write 2a outside, what are the remaining terms? 2a plus, so what is the remaining term? 3. Okay. Now, coming to these two. What is common? Is there any term common in this? Nothing is visible. So, we can take out 1 as a common. And we have minus sign also. So, minus 1 we will write here. So, if I write minus here, here sign will be changed. Minus will become plus. So, you observe, children. Here is 2a plus 3 and here is 2a plus 3. So, 2a plus 3 into, what are the remaining terms? 2a minus 1. So, 4a square plus 4a minus 3 is written as 4a square plus 4a minus 3 is equal to 2a plus 3 into 2a minus 1. So, in these two linear expressions, one is length and one is breadth. Okay, children? One more problem, children. What are the possible polynomial expressions for the dimensions of the cuboids whose volume is 3x cube minus 12x? So, what is given here? Cuboid volume. So, what is the cuboid volume? So, you all know, volume of cuboid. Is nothing but length into breadth into height. So, what is volume of the cuboid given? 3x cube minus 12x. Since degree of this is 3, so we can factorize this cubic polynomial into 3 linear polynomials. So, one is length, one is breadth, and one is height of the cuboid. Okay. So, how to do this? You observe, children. 3x cube minus 12x can be written as 3 4s are 12 into x. If I write 3 as common, and also in x cube we have 3x's and here we have 1x. If I write 3x common outside, what are the remaining terms here? X cube means 3x's are there. If I write 1x here and remain 2x's, that means x square minus 3x already I write outside. So, the remaining term is 4. So, already we have one linear polynomial and one more x square minus 4, it is quadratic. Now, we have to factorize this. 3x into, you observe, children, x square minus 4 can be written as 2 square. It is in the form of a square minus b square. X square minus 2 square. So, what is a square minus b square, children? It is a plus b into a minus b. Therefore, x square minus 2 square can be written as a plus b, x plus 2 into a minus b, x minus 2. X plus 2 into x minus 2. So, volume of the cuboid is 3x cube minus 12x, that is LBH. So, here L is 3x, B is x plus 2 and C is x minus, sorry, H is x minus 2. You can interchange the values also. It is L, it is B, it is H, whatever it is. Okay, children? Okay, children? One more. Same problem. Find the dimensions of the cuboid whose volume is 12y square plus 8y minus 20. It is just like the previous problem. So, volume of the cuboid is equal to length into breadth into height. What is given here? 12y square plus 8y minus 20. You observe, children, in previous problem we have cubic polynomial. So, we factorized with the, as three linear polynomials. But here, we have only quadratic here. Degree is 2, 12y square plus 8y minus 20. So, quadratic polynomial can be factorized as two linear polynomials only. So, how to do this? If I write it as a factorization of product of two linear polynomials, what about the value of third one? It must be 1. So, 1 is length and it is breadth and it is height. Okay. But here we can do one more other thing. That means we can take out anything. So, 12y square can be written as 4, 3 is a 12, y square plus 8y can be written as 4, 2 is a y, 4, 2 is a 8 into y minus 20 can be written as 4, 5 is a 20. So, what will be the common in all these terms? 4, 4, 4. So, if I write 4 outside the bracket, what are the remaining terms? 3y square plus 2y minus 5. Now, 4 is the length and this 3y square plus 2y minus 5, this quadratic polynomial can be factorized as 2 linear polynomials. Okay, children? You observe 3 into 5, I will say one more alternate method to factorize the quadratic polynomial. 3, 5 is a 15. Okay. So, if we write the factors for 15, if you add that, we have to get plus 2. Add or subtraction, whatever it is. You observe, children, 3, 5 is a 15 and here 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. Here we have the coefficient of y. So, I will do this as 3y square plus 2y minus 5. 3y square plus this 2 can be written as 5 minus 3 into y minus 5. Okay. So, 3y square plus now 5 into y, it is 5y and minus 3 into y. Here also we have plus, plus into minus, minus 3y minus 5. Now, we will take the common from these two terms and these two terms. So, 4 into 3y square plus 5y minus 3y minus 5. So, in this, I can write y as a common. So, 3y plus 5 remaining term. And from here, nothing is common. So, minus 1 is the common. So, the remaining terms are 3y plus 5. So, 4 into 3y plus 5 and 3y plus is common. And the remaining terms are y minus 1. So, 12y square plus 8y minus 20 can be factorized as 4 into 3y plus 5 into y minus 1. So, L, B and H. Okay, children, you will get this type of problems in your examination also. So, you try to practice it well. Okay. Okay, children, one more problem. If 2 into a square plus b square is equal to a plus b whole square, then show that a is equal to b. So, what is given? 2 into a square plus b square is equal to a plus b whole square. And what we have to prove? A is equal to b. So, you observe, children, here we are getting an identity a plus b whole square. So, what is a plus b whole square? A square plus 2ab plus b square. And here, 2 into a square plus b square. So, 2 into a square, it is 2a square plus 2 into b square, it is 2b square. If I write all the terms this side, 2a square plus 2b square, if I transform this side, plus a square will become minus 2ab minus b square is equal to 0. Plus 2a square minus a square, that is a square. Plus 2b square minus b square plus b square, and the remaining term is minus 2ab is equal to 0. You observe, children, a square plus b square minus 2ab are a square minus 2ab plus b square. It is also an identity, a minus b whole square is equal to 0. If a minus b whole square is equal to 0, definitely a minus b is equal to 0. If a minus b is equal to 0, then a is equal to b. It is the required what we have to prove. Okay, children? Okay, children? This is the polynomials and factorization, second chapter in your 9th class. We have completed this in today's class. Children, this polynomials and factorization is very important for your 10th class also. So, keep concentration on this. And also, you do the your all exercise problems. Do this, try this, think and discuss. If you have any doubts, you can ask your maths teachers. And you can watch the videos again and again. Okay, children? Thank you, all of you. All the best. I am very thankful to our DEO sir and our Khammam district team for giving this opportunity to me for taking the online classes. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.